各位朋友，大家好，我是乔学英。如果你们喜欢这个视频，请点赞、订阅并打开小铃铛，谢谢大家。今天是2021年的9月29号，我们今天要介绍的内容是美国药监局，也就是 CDC 局长 Dr. Walensky 所提供的有关接种第三针辉瑞疫苗加强剂的一些初步的信息。我们大家都知道，辉瑞的新冠疫苗的第三针加强剂啊，已经在上个星期正式的展开了。白宫的新冠疫情协调员 Jeff 在9月28号的一场简报中提到，在第一个周末，仅仅是在药房，只是在药房，就有40万的美国人接种了第三针，也有超过100万的美国人完成了预约。而 Massachusetts 和其他几个州也已经通过短信啊、电子邮件啊，通知了几百万个合格的州民。在新泽西州，当地的政府已经建立起了两个大型的第三针的接种中心，而美国退伍军人医疗中心和印第安人的医疗中心每天都有数千个人接种了第三针的新冠疫苗。美国总统拜登也带头接种了第三针疫苗，你们现在视频上看到的就是他接种第三针疫苗的情景。所以这位白宫的协调员认为，他们的第三针的接种活动有了一个非常好的开端。那么既然第三针已经如火如荼的开展了，那么有些信息呢，我们还是应该要去掌握的。当然现在只是刚刚开展，所以具体的信息并不充分，但是了解一些是一些。接下来我们就听听 CDC， 也就是美国的药品监管局的局长 Dr. Walensky 在同一场简报中提供的针对第三针接种的一些初步的信息，比如为什么要去接种第三针，什么样的人可以接种第三针，接种第三针有些什么副作用，以及对那些还没有资格接种的人，或者是接种了其他种类疫苗的人，比如 Moderna 啊，或者是 Johnson & Johnson 啊，对于那些人，他们都没有资格接种第三针的。那么对于那些人， CDC 准备了哪些对策呢？以下就是他的讲话内容，我在他讲话的视频下方附上了我翻译的中文文字，让对英文不感兴趣的朋友们参考。好，就让我们开始吧。
Thank you so much. Good afternoon. Let's begin with an overview of the data. Our 7-day average of cases is about 95,000 per day. The 7-day average of hospital admissions is approximately 8,500 per day. And the 7-day average of daily deaths is 1,300 per day. When I spoke with you last Friday, we covered CDC's recommendations and our decision to offer Pfizer vaccine booster doses to specific communities. For those who received a Pfizer primary series and who are at least 6 months after their second dose, the following Americans are eligible for a booster. Those over the age of 65. Those 18 and older who have an underlying medical condition, such as asthma, diabetes, or obesity. And those 18 and older who live or work in a high-risk setting, like a hospital, school, grocery store, long-term care facility, or a homeless shelter.
这里我打断一下，事实上 FDA 是不太赞同接种第三针的，可是 CDC 却是想把第三针普及的越多越好，所以最终的接种资格它还是比较宽松的。他的接种资格要比 FDA 所定的接种资格不知道要宽松多少，所以如果你真的有强烈的意愿要接种那第三针，你可以尽可能的与你的医生讨论，很有可能你会勉强符合这些条件中的一条。好了，回到我们的话题，沃伦斯基局长他继续的说，
Although protection against hospitalization and death remains quite high,We are starting to see these populations have some decreased protection against SARS-CoV-2 infection, likely due to both waning and to the Delta variant. Many of the people in these groups were some of the first people in the country to receive their vaccine. They also include people who, because of where they work or live, may have high rates of exposure to COVID-19. And they are the same people who remain essential to our current COVID-19 response, like healthcare workers and teachers, as well as those in frontline jobs. Their well-being is essential to keeping hospital staff, schools open, and many other essential parts of society functioning. Both FDA and CDC reviewed data on the safety of booster shots, including for those who are 18 to 64. Today, we're releasing a new publication in the MMWR that shows that COVID-19 vaccine booster doses so far are well tolerated. This report includes some of the data of our early experience with third doses that FDA and CDC reviewed when they made their recommendations about boosters. The frequency and type of side effects were similar to those seen after the second vaccine doses and were mostly mild or moderate and short-lived. If you are eligible for a vaccine booster and you have questions, I encourage you to go to vaccines.gov, talk with your healthcare provider, pharmacist, or a health professional about your current risk for COVID-19, the benefit of a vaccine booster dose, and the safety of receiving an additional dose.
在这里，我再打断一下。这个报告的题目已经在屏幕中显示出来了，就是这篇文章。这一篇文章是关于接种第三针的一些安全性问题，包括副作用在内的初步的讨论。它的链接我已经放在了视频的下方，大家可以去参阅原文。让我们回到我们的话题。好，沃伦斯基局长继续地说。
We will continue to evaluate data as it becomes available in real time and with urgency, and update our recommendations to make sure that all of those at risk have the protection they need. This includes those who receive the Moderna and J&J vaccines as their primary vaccine, and also those younger Americans who are not currently eligible for a booster dose.
到这里，我不得不再打断一下。这一段文字是在告诉那些目前还没有资格接种第三针的人，或者是那些接种了其他种类疫苗的人。CDC 呢，还在努力地收集证据，试图说服 FDA 的专家们同意为这些人接种。所以在不久的将来，大家都可以接种第三针。这就是 CDC 为这些人准备的对策。好，回到我们的话题。沃伦斯基局长他继续地说。
As I said last week, this action is an initial step related to booster shots. It will not distract us from our most important focus, to get as many people as possible vaccinated with a primary series. We remain steadfast in our effort to vaccinate as many people as possible and to continue our fight against COVID-19. Those who are unvaccinated remain the most vulnerable to infection, severe disease, hospitalization,And currently, there are over 70 million eligible Americans who remain unvaccinated. The best way to protect everyone, including those who are not yet eligible to be vaccinated, such as our children less than 12, is to vaccinate as many eligible people as possible. My closing ask to you is, if you have not been vaccinated, please do so. If your neighbor, family member, or friend has not yet been vaccinated,Please assist in providing them the resources to get there. Thank you. I'll now turn things over.
这就是 CDC 的 Walensky 在9月28号提供的针对第三针的有关信息。在最后一段，他强调，在踊跃接种第三针的同时，别忘了提醒那些还没有接种疫苗的亲戚、朋友和邻居，大家都去接种疫苗。好了，今天的视频我们就到这里结束。如果喜欢，请点赞、订阅并打开小铃铛。谢谢大家的观看，我们下次再见。